responsible for five guys and if they're looking to die.
They're training and everything. Disarm bombs and shit. In the cog of the world or the US, it didn't mean much.
You're the tip of the spear.
But in the focal point of what you're doing, you don't see anything around you, so you don't get that that you're a cog, you know that. But you're so micro focused. Like our jobs now, we're so broad spectrum focused that we seem very small. Whereas that job, you're very small, but your focus is tiny. Your focus is 12 people, maybe 20. That's it.
But I mean, the thing, everything that we're doing now is contingent on like what you used to do. If we don't have that down pat, then nothing else matters.
You don't know that.
If we can't,
I think that's true. But I think that it's. I think that we have it so down pat now. We don't need to be going to schools and being saying you need to join the military because of this. We don't need that.
Again, though,
now we did need that in World War II. We did need people.
No, World War II, we didn't need that because we could just conscript people.
That's true, yeah.
But any general will tell you they prefer having a professional military.
Again, when you take things away, they don't come back easily. So whether we need it or not, we need to continue.
The other thing, like, let's just say we reduce recruiting by like 10%, 20%, like a fairly reasonable number if you actually think about it. Yeah. Okay, that means that if we went into a major war tomorrow, right, you have one generation of troops through whatever iteration. Like, let's say you cut it for a year or 2 years or whatever.
Turnover is super high.
You got to keep people through the pipeline. And then, like, I mean, there's a huge weed out culture in the military, right?
That's true.
Like, if you don't get promoted 3 times, you're done.
I mean, you're not technically done, but yeah.
I mean, it's all about getting people into jobs that are going to be at their max level of utilization.
Maybe I just have a problem with the way they...
Oh, yeah. Recruiters will show up and they'll lie and they'll tell people one thing and they'll...
Because people are so dumbfounded, like, oh, God, they've been to my school so many times and I have to... All my friends are like, oh, military is heaven. They make it seem like you're going to go to heaven, and it's not that way, Buster. I mean,
well, here's the other...
What did you?
Here's the other funny thing that always...
That's one of the biggest jokes in the military, is a recruiter fucking... God, you should watch the miniseries, HBO miniseries, Generation Kill. There's a part in it where the guy's bitching about the recruiters, and,
But my recruiter said.
Yeah.
My recruiter said I was going to get chocolate pie.
They're driving down the road, and they're like, and the one guy's bitching that he didn't get to shoot at anyone. And they're like, Trombley, that's what your recruiter told you, didn't he? Your recruiter told you you'd get to kill people.
Yeah.
He's like, my recruiter told me I'd get to travel the world.
Oh, nice God.
Nice pussy. He's like, Trombley hasn't gotten to shoot anyone. I'm a million miles away from good tie pussy. And he's like, this other guy's like, Brad probably joined because he saw that commercial with the dude who slays the dragon with the sword.
I remember that commercial.
Yeah. Marine Corps, I think.
Yeah, it was a Marine Corps. They played it before the Harry Potter movies.
They advertise military in such a way as you're going to be like a space marine. When we're not like that, right?
Well, I mean, the Air Force literally had that commercial where it was like there were like airmen like sitting on a space station, like, praying mantis. Yeah, that no one kill that. That's our buddy. That's killing all the bugs that we don't want.
Someone put a light on it.
He's doing yoga. He's getting away. There you go.
He's going to the flame.
He won't get in the flame.
I don't know. Bugs are pretty stupid, dude.
That praying mantis has a great brain.
Oh, God, he's going to jump, dude. Those things jump.
He's going to eat
you. Yeah, I don't want him to go into the flame.
He's not going
to
go into the flame.
He's over here now. He's creeping.
He's angry.
Get back.
Well, at least we just...
You think if I touch him? Dude, he's doing the waving. He's waving. Oh, God, I'm getting back. I don't like that crap.
Turn it up.
fucking A he did.
Sergeant, I didn't get to shoot.
See, Trumley asked about shooting people. I asked about pussy. Guy told me I get to go to Thailand and get all kinds of strange. What'd you ask about, Brad? Brad probably saw that TV commercial, the one with the knight who fucks up the dragon that turns into the marine.
Dress blues with a sword.
Fucking dress blues commercial, man. I got so many fucking guys. Now look at us. Trumley hasn't killed anybody. I am half a world away from good Thai pussy. And Colbert is out here rolling around fuck butt Iraq, hunting for dragons in a mop suit that smells like 4 days of piss and ball sweat. Nice.
You have to wear a mop suit.
Sword, Brad. That would fucking rock.
I mean, they don't breathe at all, do they?
No. That defeats the purpose of you being contaminated.
Well, I mean, you're probably going to die anyway, so you might as well die comfortable.
Well, yes, that is true.
It's probably,
I brought that logic up when I was in the Army, and it did not go over. Other than mustard gas and CS, everything, the gas mask don't do much. I think mustard gas eats your gas mask in like 30 seconds. It gives you time. Loud it is. When it's cold outside, the mother made.
They found that nearly half of all U.S. adults experienced one or more dry eye symptoms regularly. 12 different subcommittees focusing on different aspects of dry eye disease, and to create a 400...
But then it's all good because Superman was played afterwards.
Oh yeah, when they brought.
But that was a good mix. Superman back then, they had, you know, they had the, you were either a kid that watched Batman or you watched the Superman show?
I watched Batman.
Yeah, but that was...
I did both. You know, there's a quick video on YouTube about Kevin Conroy who voiced Batman, and I forget who voices Superman in the animated series.
I don't know his name
but
either.
But they bring him together on a like one-off YouTube video that's like 5 minutes long.
So they do like a monologue.
Yeah, it's like Superman's like at his house, like doing the laundry and stuff. It's not they're not the characters; they're just the actors at home in California somewhere. And Superman's like doing his laundry, and like Kevin Conroy's Batman, and so he like. But as Kevin Conroy, it's just the dude is like creeping up on Superman. So like Superman would be doing the laundry, and Kevin Conroy would be like slithering from the side and just like stare at him from the back. It's pretty funny. And then Superman will be like doing watering a plant, and you like he's like he's like trying to teach his kid how to water a plant, and the kid's like, "How do you do it, Dad?" And Superman says, "No, you just have to thump at the plant. You just have to thump at the plant, thump at the plant, thump at the plant, thump Batman." Batman and Kevin Conroy comes in like whacks the shit out of him.
Have you played? Did you play a ton of video games? Not a lot.
Yeah.
Do you play? Did you play the Batman games?
Arkham series.
Yeah.
Oh yeah.
Oh, those are so good.
Arkham Asylum is probably Arkham City is probably the best. Arkham Asylum blew my mind when I played it though.
Oh yeah, no Arkham. I remember I was at a friend's house. I was at Cole Mashburn's house, and he had this new game, Justin. Yeah. You know. He always had the new games.
Yeah.
And he had Batman Arkham Asylum. I was like, what is this?
It's amazing.
And we sat in his room and played it that day until like 2 a.m. that night.
The combat in that game was like the first game I ever played that was so fluid
and
well animated. It was so... Like, you beat your Batman. Batman's this badass motherfucker. And, like, you're surrounded by 30 thugs.
And you just beat the snot out of
them. And it's, like, there was a pretty ingenious game mechanic because, like, Batman's head would flash quickly.
When they were going
to
attack.
So the thug was about to hit you. And so you just tap Y and Batman, like, goes into this, like, karate jiu-jitsu block. And it's, like, you hit Y once and he just, like, breaks a guy's arm.
But Arkham City's story is actually awesome. Like, it's one of the... It was one of the better Batman stories.
Like a group of 50 dudes, and Batman's just like, break his neck. He's killing people, throwing them off buildings. It's amazing.
Mark Hamill plays like a sick Joker.
He's the actual Joker.
Yeah, it's the Joker, but the Joker has like cancer.
Yeah.
And so he's like, but he's still
and
trying to kill him.
That's the best, actually. That's the best,
best Joker ever.
In that video game.
Oh, video game.
The best Joker, the best
Adam. Heath Ledger's been the best Joker.
No,
you have
this Joker in this Batman Arkham City is the best. Mark Hamill and better than Heath and Ma. Best Joker in anything.
Heath Ledger's a good Joker because he did a new thing.
Yeah, he did something new.
And it was.
But just about the original Joker.
No, we're just talking about over anything. This adaptation of Mark Hamill's is everything is it's better.
Yeah, and actually, you have Xbox One. They remastered Asylum and Arkham City.
So you could buy it.
HD on
the I saw it. It was like $9.99 the other day.
Yeah, the remastered one. Yeah.
Huh.
It's worth it. Big time.
But I don't know if you would actually sit down and work the time playing it.
It requires a little bit of investment, but it's a good
game. It does, but it's good. I remember when I ended Arkham City, I was like, oh my god.
It's like The Legend of Zelda for adults almost.
It's
like Ocarina of Time, but
best game ever.
I'm getting on the metro. That stuff that I printed out for our trip. Or I hadn't printed it out yet, but that stuff that I was working on and showing you guys, like all the and all the freaking like what's it called the intel and stuff. I'm going to my brother's office right now. I'm using the metro alone to get to his office and print off that stuff. So.
So I'm in the middle of this random town. I don't know if you guys can hear me. I'm in the middle of this random town, and I just got a haircut. It looks okay. I look like a Nazi youth kid. Freaking... They're playing Weezer. It's Beast. I'm in this random deli, and they're playing Weezer. So that was pretty cool. Yeah.
So there's an AMC theater here, and I'm bored, and I'm in the middle of this random city that I don't know where, like, where it is. I just came here to get a haircut and leave, but I'm gonna burn some time because there's no point in just going back home, going on the 45-minute metro. So I'm gonna watch a movie because there's an AMC theater here. I'm gonna see Skyscraper. I don't know why that was a good idea, but whatever. I don't have any good ideas. Dude, there is no one in this theater. It is completely empty in here. And look at these chairs, they're awesome. I know y'all probably can't hear me. Do these chairs like lean back or anything? I don't think so. What's this? Uh-oh. We found something, boys.
Everyone's doing it.
Oh, she's gosh. Thinking, my legs are going up. I'm going vertical. I'm going vertical. I'm going completely vertical right now. So, holy crap. I'm completely vertical.
It can't even... The screen can't even see me. It's way too loud in here. But I just got off Skyscraper, and it was fucking bomb-ass, dude. It was actually really good. I mean, it wasn't like Christopher Nolan, like, it wasn't like good, great, but it was Beast. I don't know, it was just a good action movie. Fucking bum ass. So cool. What is that? That's crazy. I'm so lost right now. I got back on the metro and I'm headed back, but I don't want to use the Uber again because it's like $7 to drive a mile. So I'm walking 2.3 miles. It says it'll take me 49 minutes, but I'm a track runner, you know what I mean? But I'm on this cool bridge. It's pretty sick. I'm about to go underneath another bridge on a bridge. That's pretty beast, you know what I mean? Whoa! All right, guys, for real, like, I'm not even joking. There might be some homeless people up here. I'll tell him before he dies. I'll tell him before I die. Before he kills me, I'll be like, upload the vlog. Ugh.
Right onto Vine Street.
It's telling me to turn right. Okay. I have Google Maps on for some reason, but I know where I'm going. I'll be okay. Don't worry, guys. Ugh. I made it up that little hill. There's someone following me. So I go to LA tomorrow, but I actually ran from that guy, by the way. He was sketchy, and my voice is almost gone. I don't know why. I sat and watched Dwayne The Rock Johnson be awesome, and it gave me puberty, you know what I mean? But anyways, the sidewalk ended on me. There is no sidewalk anymore, so I'm just walking in freaking grass on the side of the highway. I probably look like a poor person. Oh,
really hot. But I'm going to LA. We're actually flying there in the morning. But this video probably won't be uploaded until I'm actually in LA. I'm not sure. I might finish it tonight, but I'm planning on uploading like 4 videos in the same 2 days. Because I've already got 2 ready. But yeah, okay, I'm going to cross the road because I'm about to get hit by a bunch of cars. Just like all at the same time. But yeah. I hope all you guys seen your pictures went pretty good. I take mine on the 23rd. So, my homies, it is like, woo! Like, holy darn. All right. I take my senior pictures on the 23rd with this gay Nazi youth, haircut. So that'll be pretty cool. I need to stop videoing or I'm gonna run out of memory and then I'm not gonna have any LA or Ryan Cruz Heath Ledger documentary. Bye.